Hello and welcome to our session. I'm Jenny Woodbury, the Marketing Manager for FastTrack for Microsoft 365. And today with me, I have Eleanor Wirt, who is the Aperture Program Manager. Today, we are going to give you an overview of FastTrack for Microsoft 365, our Aperture service, and how you can use these benefits to help accelerate your Microsoft 365 adoption journey. So let's get started. Simply stated, FastTrack is your advisor to help you deploy Microsoft 365. It's an ongoing benefit that comes with Microsoft 365 plans and gives customers access to FastTrack specialists. Ongoing means that throughout the life of your subscription, at any point, the customer can come back and ask for deployment assistance. This deployment guidance is delivered by Microsoft and approved partners at no additional cost. We'll talk about that more in a bit, but first, let's discuss the services that FastTrack provides. FastTrack helps customers configure identity, security, compliance, and cloud management. It also helps enable teams, including workloads, chat, meetings, voice, and events, and helps guide the deployment of Windows 10, other Microsoft 365 apps, and Microsoft Edge. And last but not least, FastTrack performs email and data migration and ensures application compatibility with the Aperture service. So next, let's cover what you get with the FastTrack benefit. All customers have access to our self-service guidance, tools, and best practices that are available on the FastTrack website. For customers that have 150 or more licenses, FastTrack has partners and remote engineers who assist with onboarding, configuration, and deployment. Now, this service is remote assistance. FastTrack provides the guidance, and the customer is accountable for executing the deployment. For tenants that have 500 or more licenses, FastTrack performs email and data migrations. FastTrack's migration assistance can help you to migrate your email and file content off of Google Suite, Box, Dropbox, and of course, your on-premises platforms, including Exchange and file shares. So next, let's spend some time on what the FastTrack process involves. The journey starts by envisioning what a successful deployment will look like. And FastTrack will help you to assess where your organization is today and what actions you should plan for before, during, and after your deployment. Next, FastTrack will work with you to onboard to your cloud solutions and help you remediate those issues. As I mentioned earlier, it will also help you migrate your email and data. And throughout this process, FastTrack will also provide you with guidance and best practices to help you drive business value. Now let's look a little bit more closely at each step in the process and how FastTrack and our customers work together. During the plan phase, FastTrack will schedule an initial call and give guidance on how you can build your deployment success plan. For customers to get started, they should visit microsoft.com/FastTrack and submit a request for assistance to engage FastTrack. After that, customers are responsible for identifying the solution that they want to deploy and creating that project plan. In the assess phase, FastTrack will provide guidance on enabling the service and provide you with timelines and checklists to build that remediation plan. Meanwhile, the customer's responsibility is to gather environment data and inventory and validate their applications. They'll also set up a remediation plan. During the remediation phase, FastTrack will help you to guide the analysis and remediation for each service. We'll hold checkpoint meetings with you along the way. The customer's responsibility is to remediate the source environment and perform the hands-on configuration. In the enable phase, FastTrack guides the scenario configuration and enablement and holds checkpoint meetings along the way to evaluate the progress. Meanwhile, customers begin implementing their deployment plan. During the migrate phase, FastTrack will provide guidance to tenants with fewer than 500 licenses and will even perform data migrations for customers that have more than 500 licenses. And last but not least, as part of this whole process, FastTrack provides self-serve tools, resources, and best practices so customers can build and execute their adoption plan. Our guidance will help you to avoid common pitfalls and execute the process the right time first. Now, FastTrack's process for enabling Microsoft 365 has helped organizations globally. We've enabled more than 70,000 customers, migrated 26 petabytes of data. Today, FastTrack provides guidance in 12 languages and has web assets in 27 languages. And we have over 300 approved partners who deliver customized onboarding experiences with value-added services and are supported by FastTrack engineering resources. And finally, with Aperture, we've unblocked 70.6 million devices from compatibility issues. And speaking of Aperture, I'm going to turn it over to Eleanor, who's going to tell you more about this service.
Thanks, Jenny. We launched Aperture 2 years ago with the promise that we would help customers fix apps that didn't work after upgrading to Windows 10 or Office Pro Plus. We did this because Microsoft is committed to making sure all of your business critical apps work. Since then, we've evaluated nearly 700,000 applications and discovered that less than 0.25% of them have had issues. This is because Windows 10 and Microsoft 365 apps were built with application compatibility in mind. For that small percentage of apps that do have issues, our dedicated team of app compat experts, including Aperture managers and product engineers, will guide you through the remediation process from start to finish. Aperture is included as part of your eligible subscription at no additional cost. We work directly with you to troubleshoot and find the root cause of an application issue, then determine how to fix it. If it's an issue with a product like Windows or Office, we work with Microsoft product teams to fix it. In some cases, there are problems with third-party apps where we work directly with the software vendor to fix your issue. Or it might be an issue with your line of business application, so we can help fix your code or provide other mitigations. Our goal is to leave your business in a better state after you work with our team. This includes making your apps future-proof and resilient to subsequent product updates using remediations that don't compromise the integrity of your application's security. Since launching, we've added promises to ensure app compatibility for Microsoft Edge and Windows Virtual Desktop. You may have heard Brad Anderson announce that Aperture now supports Windows 10 on ARM devices. For Windows 10 and Microsoft 365 apps, compat shimming and settings changes are a common fix for customer issues. In this case, we work with you to create a shim or a small library where we modify the parameters that are getting passed to the API to resolve compatibility issues. For Edge, IE mode makes it easy to use all the sites your organization needs in a single browser. Edge uses the integrated Chromium engine for modern sites and the Trident MSHTML engine for IE11 for legacy sites. A common compatibility concern for Edge is with display and functionality issues that occur when accessing a site designed with legacy dependencies. These issues can be remediated by adding the site to the Enterprise Mode site list to utilize IE mode. A helpful tip for migrating to Edge is that using Enterprise Site Discovery can help you identify these legacy sites and configure your Enterprise Mode site list successfully. Windows 10 Enterprise Multi-Session enables multiple concurrent interactive sessions and is supported exclusively in Windows Virtual Desktop, also known as WVD. Customers have faced issues with moving applications currently hosted in an on-premise remote desktop session environment to Windows 10 multi-session in WVD because they are hard-coded to work only on server OS. To resolve this issue, Aperture engineers work to provide guidance for either updating the application code or updating the installer to get the application working on WVD. For customers deploying Windows 10 on ARM devices, such as the Surface Pro X, we now offer a new compatibility promise. PCs have traditionally been powered by x86 processors, but there is a growing ecosystem of PCs powered by ARM-based processors. The ARM architecture enables PCs to have additional benefits such as all-day battery life and built-in LTE cellular connectivity. Some customers have run into issues where their homegrown business apps or third-party software apps can't run on ARM processors. Our engineers provide guidance on how to recompile those apps to be ARM native and help debug issues as they arise. Now that you know a little bit about what we do, I want to share a customer success story. Recently, we helped a customer who is beta testing the Surface Pro X before rolling out 18,000 devices company-wide. They discovered that the Microsoft Local Administrator Password solution, or LAPS, could not be installed. Since LAPS is used to manage passwords, this blocked their testing efforts. Partnering with the surface engineering team, our engineers discovered that the installation issue was related to a GPO plugin that was incompatible with ARM processors. So we recompiled the application to be ARM native, and the customer's testing was successfully unblocked. Another customer success story is with a large American health insurance company. They used a shortened URL pattern as an easy way to give employees access to company's internal sites. After deploying to Microsoft Edge, the internal shortened URL links redirected incorrectly to an internet search of a word in the URL instead of to an internal site. This impacted their workflow and required unnecessary steps to access crucial internal sites. After investigation, our support engineer discovered that a forward slash in the shortened URL pattern was not considered proper punctuation. This caused it to appear as multiple words, which led to an internet search query. Our engineer engaged the Edge team to investigate further, and they quickly identified that adding the forward slash to the Edge punctuation policy list resolved the customer concern. The product team released this bug fix in the next beta version of Edge just a month after the bug was reported. The customer confirmed the issue was resolved, and more than 120,000 users were unblocked. Another happy customer. To work with Apashure, submit your request for assistance through the Apashure portal, and our router will assign your case to a dedicated Apashure manager to help resolve your issue. For more information, visit aka.ms/apashure. Have questions? Send us an email at achelp@microsoft.com. To learn more about all the FastTrack services available to you, please visit www.microsoft.com/FastTrack. Thank you for taking the time to watch our video. Our team looks forward to engaging with you on your deployment project and/or helping you solve your app compat issues should any arise.